Okay, in the future, man. That's the future, man. He said Israel shall do violently. So Israel is the one that's going to be mighty and have that power, man. Okay? And have that force and have that army, man.
Man, yeah, you going to that lexicon.
Yeah, bring out the lexicon, bro. Anything on edification.
Strength, power, might, especially warlike.
See?
To show oneself strong, to display valor, force, a host.
Valor.
So like, yes. To show oneself strong, to display valor, force a host, leader of the army, says, in that day of thy warfare.
See? So, Israel is going to be looked at as the one that got that power, man. Not Ammon. See, Moab. See, Moab looked at as if they got power right now. Okay, they'll tell you Moab got 200 million men in there. I mean, 2 million men in their military. Okay? They'll tell you that. So how many, matter of fact, Google, how many men are in the Chinese military? To get the actual facts. You know, they'll look at the Chinese military as mighty. And they'll look at the so-called white man military as mighty. But in that day, Israel is going to be mighty and take over Moab and Edom. Okay? What else in there, bro?
It says, thy warlike expect.
Expedition, yeah.
It says, thy warlike expedition, that is the day of the sending of the rod of Messiah's strength of Zion, when he rules in the midst of his enemies and strikes through kings in the day of his wrath.
See? So there you go, man. So how many is in the Chinese military, man? How many men what you got?
I pulled some up here from Wikipedia.
But you already know the American military, you know, no doubt about it. People look at that. But they also look at the Chinese military is strong, but I just want to get how many men are in there.
Okay. China's army, I looked it up here on Wikipedia, and that's the People's Liberation Army, and it has a ground force of 975,000 personnel. Mm-hmm. About half of the PLA's total manpower of around 2 million.
See? 2 million, man. So you look at that army as mighty. But guess what? Yahweh Shai, when he come back, he gonna take that army, man. It's gonna be nothing, man. That army gonna be featherweight. Because it's telling you in the prophecy, man. Featherweight, man. That's how Yahweh Shai is going to look at the kings of the earth. All of y'all featherweight. Okay. Yeah, y'all ain't heavyweight, featherweight. Okay. You see? Go ahead, bro.
It's verse 19. Out of Jacob shall come he that shall have dominion,
mm-hmm.
and shall destroy him that remaineth of the city. Verse 20. And when he looked on Amalek,
so-called Jews, the fake Jews. Go ahead.
He took up his parable and said Amalek was the first of the nations.
They ruling now, man. Go ahead.
But his latter end shall be that he perish forever.
Wiped out. Okay? That he perish forever, man. You know what that's going into? Obadiah, the 18th verse, man. Okay? Amalek, you so-called Jews, you fake Jews. As a nation of people, you're going to serve slavery, and at the end of that 1,000 years of slavery, you're going to be wiped out as a nation of people. You're going to perish forever, man. Go ahead.
And he looked on the Kenites, and took up his parable and said, strong is thy dwelling place, and thou puttest thy nest in a rock. Mm-hmm. Nevertheless, the Kenites shall be wasted, until Ashur shall carry thee away captive. Mm-hmm. And he took up his parable and said, at last, who shall live when the Most High Power doeth this?
Ha! Go ahead.
And ships shall come from the coast of Shittim, and shall afflict Ashur, and shall afflict Eber, and he also shall perish forever. Verse 25. And Balaam rose up and went and returned to his place, and Balak also went his way.
Yeah, so he told him, man, the future. Say, look, man, you can't send curses upon Israel, man. Your people in the future are finished when Yahweh Shai come back. That's what he was telling them, man. So the Chinese, y'all are finished, man. What y'all seeing is the beginning of them plagues, which them curses are easing over there on y'all, okay? But the future for y'all is y'all not to rule. The future is for y'all to be destroyed by Yahweh Shai and go into slavery, man. That's your future, man. So read what you got, bro.
And this is the book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 16 and verse 18. The beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, and the powers shall stand in fear.
Yeah, man. The powers gonna stand in fear, man. Okay, go ahead.
The beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come? Question. Mm-hmm. Verse 19. Behold, famine and plague and tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment.
Yeah, give me Revelation 19 and 11. Start there, and we're gonna read all the way down to 21. Yeah, they sent for correction, but these heathens don't get it, man. Okay, what you're seeing taking place on the earth, that famine, that pestilence, and that death is sent for correction, but these heathens don't get it. They ain't gonna get it until Yahweh Shai come back and put his foot on their neck. Okay.
They're gonna learn to fear Yahweh.
They're gonna learn to fear, and the nation of Israel, because we joint heirs, man. Up under Yahweh Shem Shai, man. You know? So go ahead, bro.
This is a Revelation.
You finna say something?
Oh.
Go ahead.
This is Revelation chapter 19, verse 11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse.
That's talking about Yahweh Shai coming in pure power, man. Okay? White represent purity, horse represent power, man. Go ahead. Symbolically. Go ahead.
And he that sat upon him was called faithful and true.
That's the characteristics or the attributes of Yahweh Shai. Go ahead.
And in righteousness, he do judge and make war.
So when he come for the Chinese, is he coming with roses? Nah, he coming for war, man. We just read it, man, in Numbers 24th chapter, man. Go ahead.
His eyes were as a flame of fire.
Angry. He coming back angry, man. Go ahead.
And his head were many, and his head,
Salaki.
And on his head were many crowns.
Yeah, that's symbolically for him taking the crown of the rulers of the earth, man. Okay? Go ahead.
And he had a name written that no man knew.
If you can receive it. Go ahead.
But he himself.
If you can receive it. Okay? Because he himself is dealing with what? You being part of the body. You one with him. So his name is Yahweh Shai. Go ahead.
Verse 13, and he was clothed with a vesture dripped in blood.
Why? Because he was putting people to death, man. That's symbolically, man. Because blood is unclean. If you got blood on you, it's unclean. But that's symbolically saying, showing you that he's coming back to put people to death, man. We letting this go by, this confusion. Man, that's just a problem. Yeah. Go ahead.
And his name is called the Word of the Most High Power.
That's an attribute, man. Characteristic. Okay, go ahead.
And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses.
That's talking about the angels and the chariots. Go ahead.
Clothed in fine linen.
Go ahead.
White and clean.
Go ahead.
And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword.
You know what that's talking about? When you watch Independence Day, when that beam came out of that so-called UFO and destroyed the Washington, D.C., that capital. That's what that's talking about, that sharp sword coming out of his mouth, meaning out of that chariot. Go ahead.
That with it he should smite the nations.
See, with it he shall smite the nations. So everybody ain't gonna be holding hands, man. He coming back for war, man, to take down these nations that's ruling, man. Okay? And Moab is one of them, man. And Edom, so-called white man, is at the top of them. Go ahead.
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
With love. With love. Like everybody quote John 3:16. With love. Nah, man. Go ahead, bro.
And he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of almighty power.
Go ahead.
And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Go ahead.
And I saw an angel standing in the sun.
What that represents is power and authority, man. Okay? You saw an angel standing in the sun. That represents power and authority, man. Go ahead.
And he cried with a loud voice, saying to all the fowls that fly in the midst of heaven, come and gather yourselves together unto the supper of the great power.
So what it is when Yahweh Shah come back and put you healings of death, you're going to end up in the belly of these five animals because they're going to be eating you. Okay? They're going to be eating your corpses. Go ahead.
That ye may eat the flesh of kings.
Go ahead.
And the flesh of captains.
See? Go ahead.
And the flesh of mighty men.
See? Go ahead.
And the flesh of horses, and of them that sit on them, and the flesh of all men, mm-hmm, both free and bond, both small and great.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Verse 19. And I saw the beast and the kings of the earth.
The beast is what? NATO and the EU. Okay? The revived Roman Empire. Go ahead.
And their armies gathered together to make war against him that sat on the horse.
See? Yahweh Shah. Go ahead.
And against his army.
So, see, these world powers that got military is going to be trying to stop Yahweh Shah from delivering the children of Israel, man. Okay? Go ahead.
It's verse 20. And the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet.
What's that? The Roman Catholic Church. Okay? And all these religions, so-called religions, are offsprings of the Roman Catholic Church. Okay? That's the false prophet. Go ahead.
That wrought miracles before him. Mm-hmm. With which he deceived them that had received the mark.
That miracle is what? That RFID chip, man. Okay? Because people look at that as a miracle when you can walk when you was paralyzed. People look at that as a miracle. Okay? You can open a house door, open a car door, start your car with no key, just using that chip. People look at that as a miracle, man.
Or a man, maybe a man that's in a wheelchair and he's got the RFID chip and he can just suddenly just get up and start walking.
Yeah, like I was saying, yeah walking. Or he can speak, or he can speak or hear you when he can speak or hear you from the day that he couldn't speak when he was born, He couldn't hear you when he was born, but all of a sudden now, since he got that chip, he can hear you and speak. That's a miracle.
Yeah, make the deaf hear again.
Yeah, make the deaf hear again, man. So read that again, bro. Dealing with what verse is that?
Verse 20.
Yeah, read 20 again.
This is Revelation chapter 19, verse 20. And the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet that wrought miracles before him.
All right, the camera about to go off.
Ha ha ha!